guys and dolls, I'm cooking some dinner. So yeah, I'm going to show y'all how to do my super duper easy breezy fish recipe.
Okay, so in the recipe, I've got, this is just white fish, okay? It's just plain cod, wild caught cod, white fish. You can use any kind of fish you want, and you can change up the seasonings as you want, and I'll tell y'all kind of what I do about that. And then you'll need something that is a fat. You can use an oil if you want to. I like to use butter just because it's, to me, it's more healthful. But anyway, I'm going to be using some butter. I'm going to be using some onion powder, not salt. I'll be using some seasoned salt here, and then I'm going to be using a little bit of some basil and some oregano, all right? Now, if instead of, you know, if you don't have something like this, basically this is just to give it a little bit more flavor. You can use something like some Italian herb mix seasoning, okay? So that's going to be all that you need to do, all right? And I'm going to be using one of these lovely spatulas here from Chef, Elite Chef. And this is a fish spatula, and I'm going to show you, you know, why you really pretty much need a specific tool, you know, to do fish and to do it well. For those of you that don't know, most white fish, they flake a lot. It's going to flake a lot. So you need something that's going to be able to scoop up, basically, the fish without it falling apart. So what I'm going to start with here is I've just got a cast iron pan, and you can use any kind of pan, all right, so don't be intimidated by that. Any kind of pan, and I've got this little bit higher than medium, just a little bit higher, okay? Now, the great thing about this is that I'm literally not going to measure, okay? Now, on a pan this big, what you're going to need is to make sure there's oil, fat, whatever. I'm going to be using butter, you know, in the bottom of this, and I've got three pieces, so you can see they're pretty much going to fit in that pan. If you've just got a small pan and you're just cooking one fish fillet for yourself, then don't worry about it. Just use, you know, about what I'm going to do. Now, if you've ever been to a restaurant and you've gotten the butter, a butter pat is about a tablespoon, okay? This is bigger than a tablespoon because this is like a giant spoon, but I'm going to basically be kind of doing three pats plus a little bit more butter. So one pat per fillet, all right? So I'm just going to go in here into my butter. I'm literally not measuring it, and I'm just going to put it in the pan. You can see there that it's getting nice and melty. Ooh, that's too much. Don't get half a stick. Okay, that is probably good there, and I'm going to let that melt a little bit, and then once it's melted, I will come back to y'all, so hang tight. Okay, y'all can see the butter is nice and melty in there. And at the medium setting, a little bit higher, remember, a little bit higher than medium setting, look at the butter there. And can you see that it's starting to, you know, starting to bubble a little bit? Okay, so that means it's ready to go. We want it to go just a little bit longer. So all I'm going to do here on these fish, all right, is... So when you have them in the pan, you know, the sides that are a little bit thinner, of course, they're going to cook quicker than the thicker part does. So that's why you may want to cook a little bit more, you know, if you've got multiple people eating, because then that way if it gets too cooked, you can cut off that little edge, okay? But literally, I haven't changed the temperature or anything. We're just going to leave that in there. You're going to want to do about 4 minutes per side. So let's go ahead and set the timer here, and I'm not going to make y'all sit and watch the video for 4 minutes. Boringness. Watching fish cook. Okay, so here we go. I will be back when they are ready to flip. Okay, one thing I forgot to mention was that while it's cooking, what I like to go ahead and do is I season the other side while it's in the pan. So if you remember, first we started with the salt, and again, I'm not measuring. I'm just putting it straight in there on the fish, and then go with a little bit of the, again, this is onion powder. Just sprinkling it. See how I'm just sprinkling it? This is how you take the stress out of cooking in the kitchen, all right? It's all about
what you like to eat, what flavors you like, you know, your family, what flavors they like. Because for the oil, you know, you could try a flavored oil, you could try, you know, olive oil, you could try an oil that's infused with something if you didn't want to go the butter route. Anything like that's fine. Same thing with seasoning. Don't feel like you have to stick with these seasonings, but the secret is to have a salt and then to have a powder, you know, whether it's onion powder, garlic powder, etc., and then have something green. Greek seasoning would be yummy on this, you know. I can think of like dill with salmon, or, you know, mint with some, maybe some swordfish, etc. So again, we're just going to wait and let this cook. And the reason why I went ahead and seasoned this is because as it's cooking, these flavors are going to be able to mingle on this side as well. But notice I'm not managing the fish. You know, I just put it in the pan, I just set the timer, and then we're just letting it go. So I'll be back this time when they're ready to flip. Okay, so it's ready to do the flip test. Now, one of the wonderful things about using a cast iron skillet is that they're pretty much almost automatically non-stick, especially if you use a butter or oil or something like that whenever you're pan frying something, which is basically what we're doing. Now, regardless of the pan that you have, because I have one that's all stainless steel and I cook the fish in that as well, but that's the great thing about having something like a fish spatula is because it's specifically designed to scoop underneath the fish. You know, it's got a thin edge on it, it's metal, so it's going to get the fish without tearing it apart. And that's one of the things that I think prevents people from cooking fish, which is a very healthy food to eat, is that it ends up tearing apart, all right? So the secret is to keep it on medium to low heat constantly. Don't mess with it, and then when it's time to flip it, flip it. So again, this is from Elite Chef, and we're going to, you know, basically put this to the test right now. So here's our fish ready to go. Very simple. Look how easy that is, okay? And you'll notice how I'm just getting right to the edge of the fish and then giving it just a little bit of a jiggle. Chasing this one around the pan a little bit. Come here, little fish. There we go. Now look at how great that looks. Look at that edge. Look. Now do you see how the fish is kind of coming apart there a little bit? That's okay. That's, you know, what white fish is going to do, and especially a flaky fish is going to do this. But look at how delicious that is. It's not a crust. That's just from the butter in the pan, or, you know, whatever oil you're going to use, the juices and the seasoning. So there you go. That's just one side. So again, we want to go ahead and set that timer for 4 more minutes. And so far, this is a fantastic spatula. So let me go ahead and set that timer, and I'll be right back. Okay, now while we're waiting for that fish to cook, let me just talk a little bit more about the Elite Chef fish spatula. This is the black handled one. It's basically a plastic handle, but the spatula part is the same as what's in the metal one. Now, I like the metal one just because it goes with my other kitchen tools, to be honest with you. But it's got this rubber grip, you know, that's on it, so where you can, you know, really hold on to it well. It's got the, you know, nail hook or the hook if you want to put it in the wall, etc. And these are just wonderful. And I can actually see myself using these, like if I'm sauteing vegetables that may be a little bit more tender that have a tendency to fall apart, or a lot of other uses for this fish spatula, again from Elite Chef. So they have been so kind as to not just send me one, and not to just send me two, but to actually send me 4 fish spatulas. So I'm keeping 2 for myself, but I'm going to give away 2 to 2 different viewers here on the channel. So if you're interested in getting one of these fish spatulas, I want you to go over to facebook.com/getrealwithwesleygw. Look for this video, okay? And then underneath that video, I want you to tell me if you've cooked, if you tried this fish recipe and how it turned out for you, or you can tell me why you think you really need to have the fish spatula from Elite Chef. Also, if you just can't wait and you want one of these spatulas no matter what, Fish Spatula Company, or not company, Elite Chef that's giving us the fish spatula is so nice that they actually gave coupon codes. So if you just look in the description below, there'll be a link for the stainless steel one and a link for the black handled one.
And then the appropriate coupon codes with each one of those. So go on over. They're going to give a 25% discount, which I think is pretty fantabulous. So we've got a couple more minutes here until our fish is ready to serve up. So I'll come back in just about 2 minutes. All right, so we are ready to take these fish up out of the pan. Now, one trick I forgot to tell you is that when you're cooking the second side of the fish, sometimes the pan, you know, because it was heating up, sometimes it gets maybe too hot. And so one thing you can do in, like, on a cast iron is that you can go ahead and actually turn off the heat altogether and just let the fish, in this case, sit in the pan. And that pan's going to stay hot for, like, the last 2 minutes of cooking. If you've got a stainless steel pan, you can either turn down the temperature or you can turn it off as well, you know, as long as it's, you know, if you're feeling like the fish maybe is going to burn if you leave it on for too long. Always a good idea just to turn down the heat, especially on a non-cast iron, because they don't really hold their heat as much. So let's go ahead and scoop these bad boys up. Now this is when it gets tricky, because as you can see, things get a little bit stickier when it's been cooking, you know, for the full time. The first time it's not so hard to flip, but this is when the true test comes of especially this kitchen tool. All right, now this guy I'm just going to scoop up as he is, and you saw he was kind of holding on there a little bit, so all I did is went at another angle. Oops, and now I'm going to pick this guy up, and notice I am doing this one-handed, so that does take some skill and finesse. This guy right here, I'm actually going to turn him over because I want you to see what they look like on the reverse side too. And see, that's just lovely. Look at how delicious and appetizing that looks. I'm going to go back here, over here, and then flip a dip, and there we go. So delicious, delicious, super easy, no pain, no stress fish, all right? Now, all I did, these were frozen. I had thawed them in the fridge overnight, took them out, washed them off, just rinsed them off with some water, put them on a plate. You saw me season the one side. I put the butter in the pan, let it heat. While it was doing that, I was seasoning the one side, put it into the pan, seasoning side down, leave it alone, set the timer for about 4 minutes, you know, season that one side that's not facing down, let it do the cooking time. Get in there with your Elite Chef fish spatula. Flip one time. Don't mess with it. Just flip it the one time. Again, another 4 minutes on the other side. And then, voila, there you go. So this smells too good, and I can't talk to y'all anymore because I've got to go eat. So on that note, remember, if you want to enter to win either the black-handled one or the stainless steel-handled one, then go over to facebook.com/getrealwithwesleygw, find that video, and give me the information in the comments area. Or, hey, better yet, go ahead down to the description under this video, pick which one you want, the black one or the stainless steel one, and go order it and get 25% off. So on that note, guys and dolls, have a delicious, delightful, delirious day, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.